two, three, go!
So this is Rev Mode. This is a perfectly normal Tetris being played exactly how Tetris was meant to be played.
Yes.
That's it. That's the that's all the commentary I have for this entire run. Yeah,
so you notice that before we were stacking with our Tetris well to the right. I'm stacking with it to the left now because the game is essentially rotated 180 degrees.
Yeah, if you really want to cheat, you can put this code on and then stand behind your arcade cabinet and control the controls with your hands swapped. I've actually tried it, and it does work.
Double
it just makes your neck hurt
reverse.
Really, really bad. So, yeah, doing it legitimately, staring at it like this, like Enchantress is doing, is really hard. It takes a lot of practice to kind of reshape your brain to make this work.
Yeah, it was basically like a year of learning Tetris from scratch to get my first GM in this.
Yeah, and as we said earlier, Eon is the only Grandmaster ranked Rev Mode player outside of Japan.
Yeah, there's only one person who cleared it, right? But he didn't fulfill the requirements.
Yeah, he was a little slow. He got an S8 rank and was about a minute behind the time requirement as well.
Boy, what a casual.
Right? Yeah, honestly.
Oh, mathed myself.
Dang it.
Okay.
So yeah, for the first part of the game, this is really kind of the same as playing the 8-way, except for, you know, going the right direction this time. Yeah. We are going to be attempting to upstack to a pretty decent height for the same time attack purposes as we were downstacking earlier.
You
not
had that
quite
flipped.
As...
I think you have that flipped. Yeah, she's trying to downstack, right?
I'm
build a
trying.
Lot of material. It's confusing, I know.
I am trying my best. If this mode hurts your brain, you're not alone. It hurts mine too.
Yeah.
It really took me like multiple hours of playing over multiple sessions before I stopped like getting headaches from playing it too much. So.
Yeah. If you think that like, you know, if you're maybe a decent Tetris player and you think, you know, oh, this doesn't seem that bad, right? It would just take a little while of getting used to. Well, I suggest that you try it for yourself.
Yeah, because, it is significantly more difficult than it looks.
Another annoying thing about playing this game is, so of course, you're pushing the pieces up. You use up on the joystick, which normally is never used in this game.
Yes, up is normally a safe button or a safe direction to press. So if I'm throwing a piece over to the side and trying to quickly tap it back. Sometimes a common misdrop for me is to lock it before I tap it back.
Yeah,
because, you know, normally, like, in standard play, you just kind of roll your hand through up because it doesn't matter. It doesn't do anything. And then so if she does that here, then they'll just lock the piece.
Yep. This mode is just you have to, like, physically and mentally completely relearn Tetris. It's absolutely, absolutely insane.
Ah, I got those nice call-outs.
These combo strats.
And the combo.
Oh, baby.
Okay.
That was, like, several singles in a row. That was amazing.
I'm going to try the Tetris line clear.
Yo, the Tetris line clear... Shoutouts to Tetris Concept. The Tetris Company, one of the TCs. A couple of days ago, they discovered some incredible new Tetris tech and tweeted it to us about how if you're looking for new Tetris strats, you should try the Tetris Line Clear.
Yeah.
Eon, you had an opportunity to do the reverse Babe come to column 5 there, and I'm very disappointed in you for not doing it.
Sorry, I just saw a piece I could put under there. So now we're in awkward G, so things are starting to get a little fast.
Yeah, we call this awkward G because while being very fast, it's not 20G. Oh, nice hover. So sometimes it can be very unpredictable where your piece is going to end up when you hold left or right. It might make it over some gap halfway down the playfield, and it might not. Especially, it's particularly annoying because not only is the gravity like this, it continually changes, and it actually even goes back down. It reaches a peak at, I think, level 370, then goes down until level 420, and then starts going up again and until the maximum. I don't know. It's confusing.
We call it awkward G for a reason.
Yeah.
That is kind of what you need to know.
This is looking good.
Applause for the Tetris line clear, yes.
It's rare new tech, you know. Top Tetris researchers spent many hours figuring out that this was possible.
Who knew that there was a better move than a T-spin triple?
I don't know what that is.
Shoutouts to Right Side Tetris Wells.
What is a Right Side Tetris Well? I've never heard of this.
We know what that is, and it's the wrong thing, but it's she's making it work.
So the generally safe way to play in Aqua G, in Aqua G time, is to basically play it like it's really slow 20G, but we want to go a little bit faster than that. So we're going to be trying to take advantage of some of Aqua G's leniency without making it too difficult for ourselves.
All right.
This is fine.
Oh, that's really bad.
This is fine. I have never seen a better game in my life.
Yeah, so she's really going to need to deal with these nice triple rotate, but unfortunately gets the wrong. Okay, and give an eye. An eye. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. All right. It can be so hard to deal with center holes. Yeah, stopped at 499, so that's halfway through the game.
And yeah, and just
it turns out rev mode is really hard still.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I've only gotten 3 GMs. Earlier today, I got a PB improvement by 17 seconds, so.
Yeah, that's like 3 ever.